Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today we're gonna cover 5 3ds Max features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 1,000 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known, unknown depths of 3ds Max. So the scene that I'm gonna be using here is this beauty, and it's of course made by Evermotion. So this is their latest Archmodels Vol. 272, it's furniture sets and props. So how does it work? You can buy one of these sets, and in it you get a lot of props, you get furniture, so you can really kind of equip your scene with this. It's not just, you know, like a chair, a table, this is a whole thing. So I highly suggest that you check out Evermotion's website. As you can see, you have a lot of these furniture sets here. The set that I'm going to be using is this one. So head over to Evermotion website, check these out. I think these are worth checking. But now, when it comes to our tips in our known unknown depths of 3ds Max, our first feature is going to be instance controller in clone options. So whenever you select a couple of objects, let's say like this, table and two chairs, and you group them, and now you want to clone that group because, I don't know, it's gonna be a hall and there are gonna be many tables, whatever. You would always clone it as a copy or instance or reference. But have you ever tried pressing on the instance here? When you click under the controller, when you click on the instance, you are actually instancing the movement of the object within the group. And let's say select a chair here, and when you move it, you can notice that that chair moves in your first group also. So you're basically instancing whatever movement or rotation or scales are happening in that group, this thing got you covered. So our next feature is for our future selves or for your colleagues at work, and it's called Note. So when you're in Max, just hit X and type Note. Once you type Note, you have Add Pop-up Note. Click on that and you can leave a message. Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. And you click on Add Note. Now when you save a file like that and when you open it again, that note will automatically pop up to whoever is opening that file, whether it was you just writing, you know, some little things from the project for your future self, like for example your version of the rendering engine that you used, or it's just an information for your colleague on whoever is gonna open the scene. This is a super useful feature and you always get that note. Once you click OK, you can hit X again and type Note again, and you can delete a pop-up note, you can read it again, or you can suppress it. I would always, you know, leave like notes for my colleagues, and I would write stuff in splines and in Max's text, but now I just use notes and it's clear as a day. Our next feature actually came from a user named Alpine Rage. So I hope I pronounced it correctly, Alpine Rage. It's hide by hit or freeze by hit. I had no idea this existed. Check this out. When you go to the display tab here, you have freeze options and you have hide options. Look at this, hide by hit. Click it and whatever you click will just become hidden. This is a super useful feature. The same goes with freeze by hit. So you click here and whatever you touch, it will just be frozen. And of course, if you don't want to go to the display tab, you can just hit X and just type hide by hit. Here it is, and you can start hiding stuff, or freeze by hit and just freezing stuff. Our next feature is group attach. Now, I thought that literally everybody knows this, but yeah, I remember that I also didn't know about it at one point. So this is what it is. You select these objects, you want to group them, and you group them, nice. Now, you forgot to group this object, or you want to add this object to this group. What I see people do is they would select the group, go to group, ungroup, and then they would select everything and group again, and that would be it. But get this, when you have just this group, you can just click on your chair, group, click attach, and you just hit this group, and this is now a part of the group. Bam! Our next feature is a modeling feature, and it's dot loop and dot ring. So dot loop and dot ring, so go to your editable poly, and here under the modeling section, you have these two buttons, dot ring, dot loop. So what do they do? Whenever you select an edge, if you click this button here, it's gonna select every other edge. So this is very useful when you need to select a couple of things which are, you know, divided by one set of polygons. Now, if you go to modify section, you have the dot gap here. If you increase the dot gap to, let's say, 2, look at this, I'm gonna select this edge, I'm gonna click on dot loop, and it's gonna select every third edge. The same thing goes for the dot ring here. When you click it, it's just gonna vertically select all the things. I think this is a super useful feature because I remember maybe too many times where I was just manually selecting things like that. And yeah, It could have been done faster. Now, our last feature is actually a sixth feature, which is a mini bonus feature. It's reference coordinate system. So what is that? It's a button, but look what it does. So for example, how many times you have a teapot, as you can see, it's under an angle and we are in the move tool. And let's say I'm going to have my move tool on the view here. And you know how the pivot looks when it's set on the view coordinate system. If you go to rotation, you can set your rotation to be local, for example. It's gonna move the teapot on the local axis. When you go to scale, for scale, you're gonna be in, I don't know, world. Doesn't really matter. So whenever I would now go back to these modes, for example, rotation, it will be local, move, it will be view. Well, I figured out that this frustrates me a lot. So whenever I would, you know, set my move tool to be local, I kind of want all the others to be local as well. And then I would always manually have to go up and just change them all to be local. Well, there is a button for that. So when you go to customize, preferences, here you have reference coordinate system, just click constant. When you click on constant, look at this. I'm gonna set my move tool to local, go to rotation, it's local still, scale, still local. And that's it, this will stay locked. If you go to gimbal, so move gimbal, rotation gimbal, scale gimbal. And that's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching Evermotion. Thank you for sponsoring this video. And yeah, don't forget to go to Evermotion website, Archmodels Volume 272, check it out, and see you in the next video. Bye.